I give you Jesus in the name of the Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. I welcome you all to this morning devotion.
Thank you.
respond responsibly to God, not right. Verses 1-11. Psalms 1-11. Who give thanks to the Lord, call on his name, make known his deeds among the people.
Sing to him, sing praise to him, tell of all his wonderful works.
Glory in his holy name, that the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Bless the Lord at your ministry, receive his Christmas and your peace.
Offspring of the servant of the Lord, children of Jacob, his chosen ones. He is mindful of his covenant forever on the world that he is commanded for the thousand generations.
The covenant that has been made with Abraham, he has sworn on the promise to Isaac,
which is confirmed with Jacob as his tradition, in which Russia has every other concern. Please be seated. Now I invite the witness to come forward and lead the scripture for us.
For today's morning devotion, the Old Testament lesson has been taken from the book of Job, chapter 33, verses from 19 to 25. The book of Job, chapter 33, verses from 19 to 25. They are also chastened with pain upon their heads, and with continual strife in their bones, so that their lives loathed bread, and their appetites dainty food. Their flesh is so wasted away that it cannot be seen, and their bones, once in my spoon, now stick out. Their souls draw near the pit, and their lives to those who bring death. Then, if they should and an angel, a mediator, one of a thousand, one who declares a person upright, and he is gracious to that person and says, deliver him from going down into the pit. I have found a ransom. Let his flesh become fresh with you. Let him return to the days of his youthful vigor. Here is the lesson.
Today our morning devotion, the New Testament lesson has been taken from the book of Gospel of Mark, chapter 14, verses 12-16. Gospel of Mark, chapter 14, verses 12-16. On the first day, unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him, where do you want us to go and make the preparations for you to eat the Passover? So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you, follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the warden of the house, teacher asks, where is my guest room, where I may eat the Passover with my disciples? He will show you a damp room upstairs, furnished and ready-made preparations for us there. So the disciples set out and went to the city, and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. Here ends the reading. Let's pray for our country, for our people, and for our families, and for all blessed with peace with God. Let's pray. Our gracious and most merciful Father, we bow our heads at your feet. You are the Almighty God, and your ways are always peaceful. We pray for our churches, and also we pray for our Christians. Who believe in your holy name, please give us your strength. We pray for our nation. We pray for our political leaders and all the other officials, giving wisdom about kingdom and your guidance. We pray for our colleges. We pray for our faculty teaching and non-teaching staff workers and all the students. We pray for the peace to the world. We particularly pray for all the nations who are heading for wars, change their minds and pray peace among all the nations. We also pray for Ukraine and Russia as they have gone through the war. Please help them to go back their finance and then keep them safe. We submit our sins to you. We also pray for our families back home. As we are about to travel back home, give us safe journey and provide us with your riches. In Jesus' mighty precious name, we pray. Amen. Now I welcome Mr. Samuel, we find here to give you a special.
The case of God is a meal, the significance, the cases of Christmas.
spiritual body to be a guardian with the sinners. Today, for this text, I have titled as the Last Supper. I want you to share about the preparation of this supper, this delayed, and to understand why the Last Supper is significant, that what it means in our life, in our lives today. First thing, preparation for the supper. Our text says, the disciples come to Jesus wanting to know. He wanted to observe the Passover meal. The Passover was the main feast of Jewish religious year. It was to be held on 14th day of the first month of the Jewish calendar. About the Exodus, chapter 12, verse 6. The first month of the calendar roughly corresponds with April on our own calendar. The Passover was feast designed to commemorate the night born Passover in Israel when the death angel destroyed the firstborn of Egypt. During the last of 10 plagues, God sent to judge Egypt. The Passover was also called the Feast of Unleavened Bread, because no yeast or leavened bread was to be used or even kept in house during the days of the feast. The requisites for the Passover are found in Exodus chapter 4, according to verses 1 to 11. After the passage, every family in Israel was to take the following steps. They were to choose a lamb which was to be killed on the evening of the Passover, according to the Exodus chapter 4, 3 to 6. They were to take the bread of the lamb and put some on the doorpost of their homes. They were to roast the lamb over a fire and the bitter herbs and unleavened bread. They were to eat this meal plus cup for their journey with their shoes on, their walking sticks in their hands, and they are to eat it as a ritual they were hired. The order of meal is as follows. They drank a cup of red wine, mixed it with water. There was a ceremonial washing of hands, which symbolized the need for spiritual and moral cleaning. They ate the bitter cups, which symbolized their bodies in Egypt. They drank a second cup of wine, at which time they went, the head of the household explained the meaning of Passover. They would be singing the first two of the health songs, 113 to 114. Next, the lamb was brought out, and the head of the household distributed pieces of meat with the unleavened bread. The unleavened bread symbolized that there was no time to allow the rice before the journey would begin. They drank a third cup of wine. Then they concluded the meal by singing the rest of the Hallelujah song, 115 to 118. This was the meal the disciples were asking about Orthodox. Jews still observe the Passover the same way it has been observed for thousands of years. Sadly, they are obviously to its symbolic meaning. It will be worth our time to stop here and talk about the Passover meal, because it is a wonderful picture of worship and work of the Lord Jesus Christ. The feast involved a lamb. Notice that God for Israel to choose a lamb. This could have been lamb at all, then it is called the lamb in Moses' court. This refers to the particular lamb that was chosen for the meal, then it is called the lamb in Moses' 5. This means the meal very personal. They were to select the lamb on the tenth day of the month, and they were to keep the lamb until the 14th day of the month. There would be an attachment that would develop between family and the visiting lamb. This was intentionally what prompted them to see the high cost of sin. He wanted them to understand salvation is an intensely personal business. Jesus Christ is not just a savior. The same work is not accomplished in your life until you can say that Jesus is your Savior. Have you ever lived every other hope of salvation you have embraced the Lord Jesus Christ as a Savior? The Lamb was to be without blemish. This is a picture of perfection and purity. This Lamb speaks of the Lord Jesus become. He is also without blemish. He is the sinless Savior according to 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 22. The Lamb was to be slain and bled upright to the doorpost of the house. The family was to be there inside the house and eat the meal. When the death angel passed through the land, killing all the personal children, those who are in homes, with bled on the doors will be saved. Again, this is the picture of Jesus Christ. The only shelter anyone has against the wrath of Almighty God is the blood of Christ. If you ever hope to be saved, you must submit Jesus Christ in faith and then when you do. His blood washes every sin away. According to the Revelation chapter 1 verse 5, His blood is the only shield against the wrath and judgment of God. The Lamb was to be roasted with fire. Fire is a picture of judgment, and it is human strife that the judgment of God was being poured out on sinful Egypt, and the only thing that prevented Israel from being judged along with Egypt was the blood of the Lamb who had died to save them. The Lamb had been judged in their place. This is also pictures the Lord Jesus, who was judged in the place of Israel. Read on once. According to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 21. The lamb had to be eaten. It did no good to simply select a lamb. It did no good to just kill the lamb. The lamb had to be appropriated by the individual. The same is true with Jesus. His death on the cross is meaningless for you until you receive him by faith. His death cannot save you until you turn to him and receive him into your hearts and life. Listen to what the word of God says. John chapter 3:16. Have you received Jesus as a Savior? This is much more than that could be said about the Passover and the Lamb. These few thoughts simply remind us that salvation is not an option, it is a necessity. If you do not know Jesus Christ as a Savior, we will face God in judgment someday. If you are saved by His grace, we will never face the eternal wrath of God. His blood has forever gone away the wrath of God from those who will use you. Some people do not like talk about the blood. They make fun of His baptism with a bloody statue of religion. I hope just remind you that there is no salvation apart from the shed blood of Lamb. You may not like the blood, but it is the blood of Jesus that washes all sin away. The blood of Jesus is the only thing that can return to the lost sinner to a holy God. I think I will just stick within the blood. I think I will just keep preaching the blood. I think I will just keep rejoicing the blood. I hope you will never look at the Lord's the same way again. I hope you will be thankful, grateful and fulfilled with the Lord for a Creator who paid such a high price for our redemption. It might just be that we would like to face Him today. It might just be that we would like to get around these altars and worship Him for all He has done for you. It must just be that someone here has never been saved. Today the Lord spoke into your heart. So as we are preparing for our future ministry of Kwana, Kamai, we should give reverence to the Lord's Supper and be as a role model to the churches. He is calling you to come to Him. If that is your condition, please come to Jesus Christ today and trust Him to save your soul.
Now you can close the worship with prayer, God's prayer, and benediction. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for the wonderful work that you have given us. Help us to walk in your ways and give reference to your deep love, beauty, and forgiveness. We believe you have helped us to walk through your cross, wash our wrongdoings in your